Most people save for retirement with IRAs or 401ks. The very wealthy, they're in a different league, hedge funds. These aren't your bank's mutual funds. They're finances heavy hitters, moving billions in the shadows. No billboards, no ads, but they're steering markets. Today, we're pulling back the curtain, what they are, how they work, and why they matter. Picture a private investment club, invitation only. No 401ks, no random walk-ins. This is the VIP lounge of investing. A hedge fund is a private investment partnership that uses aggressive strategies, like short selling, leverage, and derivatives, to chase high returns. Unlike mutual funds, hedge funds are mostly unregulated and only take money from wealthy individuals or institutions. The idea isn't to beat a benchmark. The goal is to make money in any market, up, down, or sideways. That's where the hedge comes in. Most hedge funds are structured as limited partnerships, LPs. The general partner, GP, makes investment decisions. The limited partners, LPs, are the investors. They're not involved in day-to-day operations. To limit personal liability, the general partner is usually set up as its own LLC. That shields the people running the fund, portfolio managers, executives, from being personally sued if something goes wrong. The investors, limited partners, already have limited liability by default. But without this setup, the fund managers could be on the hook personally for trades gone bad, lawsuits, or regulatory trouble. Hedge funds aren't boxed in like mutual funds. They can short stocks, use leverage to boost returns, and trade derivatives. Hedge funds avoid SEC regulation by only taking money from accredited or qualified investors. They're not allowed to advertise. That freedom and flexibility means they can make money whether markets rise or fall. The trade-off? Risks that would rattle most people. Originally, hedge funds did exactly what the name says, hedge risk. They'd go long on stocks they believed would rise and go short on others they thought might fall. If the market dropped, the short positions would gain value, offsetting the losses on the longs. In other words, the goal was to stay protected either way, not just bet big in one direction. This approach is called a hedged position. Instead of gambling everything on one outcome, you build in a safety net. Today, many hedge funds don't hedge at all. They're focused on maximizing returns, not minimizing risk. They might load up on tech stocks, use leverage to double down, and make aggressive bets on market trends. Let's be honest, calling them risk-taking funds or leveraged speculation vehicles would be more accurate. But the name hedge fund has stuck. Some hedge funds don't care what a company does, they care what its price does. Statistical arbitrage, or StatArb, uses math and models to find pairs or groups of assets that usually move together. When one drifts away from the other, they bet the gap will soon close. For example, two tech stocks normally trade in sync. One dips slightly, too slightly to justify a fundamental reason. The model says it'll revert. The fund buys the cheap one, shorts the expensive one, and profits when they realign. It's not traditional investing, it's pattern recognition and probability done at speed. What's more, these funds operate on a scale that retail traders can't touch. Some hedge funds gain an edge not by predicting price movements, but by simply seeing them before you do. This is called latency arbitrage, a strategy that takes advantage of delays in how quickly market data becomes available to the public. Most investors rely on a consolidated public feed, which collects data from many exchanges and publishes the best available prices. That feed is slightly delayed by fractions of a second, but for firms trading at extremely high speeds, that delay is meaningful. To get ahead, some hedge funds pay for direct data feeds from each exchange. These firms rent space inside the exchange's data center, a practice called co-location. Their servers sit inches from the matching engine, shaving microseconds off what the public sees. For example, if they see a large buy order appear on one exchange before it's reflected in the public quote, they can buy the stock at the older, lower price and sell moments later at the higher price once the market catches up. This strategy requires custom infrastructure, dedicated lines, and precise automation. It's legal, but not accessible to ordinary traders. Some hedge funds specialize in companies that are in serious trouble, often on the brink of bankruptcy. These funds buy the company's debt, not its stock. That means they're lending money to a business that may not survive. But if the company stabilizes, even slightly, the value of that debt can rise sharply. Sometimes the fund simply holds the debt and waits, hoping the company improves and the market recognizes the change. Other times, the fund gets actively involved, talking to management, working with other lenders, or taking part in bankruptcy proceedings. It's a mix of financial analysis and legal work. This part of the market tends to have fewer players, partly because it takes a lot more work and a lot more money. The research is complex, involving legal filings, debt covenants, and sometimes court proceedings. The investments are often illiquid, and outcomes can take months or years to play out. But for funds that have the resources and expertise, distressed debt can be a highly profitable niche. Hedge funds are in the business of managing other people's money. In return, they take a cut through management and performance fees. The standard fee model is called 2 and 20, 2% of assets under management every year, 20% of profits if they make money. Suppose a fund manages $25 billion, that 2% brings in $500 million no matter how the market performs. Then if they earn a 15% return, a $3.75 billion profit, they take 20% of that, $750 million. Total for the fund, $1.25 billion. The remaining $2.5 billion goes to the clients. Most hedge funds use a high water mark. That means they only collect performance fees on new gains. If they lose money 1 year, they can't charge again until they recover that loss. After all, clients don't want to pay for a comeback that just gets them back to where they started. Hedge funds run lean. A fund managing $25 billion might only have a few hundred employees. That's a lot of responsibility, and with that comes big rewards. Of course, not everyone is paid equally. Portfolio managers and senior quants earn far more than junior analysts. Hedge funds depend on a mix of financial expertise, engineering, and business infrastructure. Portfolio managers decide what to buy and sell. Traders execute those decisions, sometimes manually, sometimes algorithmically. Risk managers monitor the portfolio to keep exposures in check. Many hedge funds are tech-driven. Quantitative developers build the systems for trading, data, and risk. Quant researchers and data scientists develop the models, often using statistics and machine learning. And behind the scenes, operations, legal, and compliance teams handle investor relations, settlements, and ensure everything stays within regulatory bounds. As an employee, what can you expect in return? Significant pay that often combines base salaries with performance bonuses. At top funds, those bonuses can be substantial. Only accredited investors and qualified purchasers can invest in hedge funds. But even within that exclusive group, there's a wide range of players. Take CalPERS, the largest public pension in the US. At one point, they put $4 billion into hedge funds. By 2014, they pulled out, saying, among other reasons, the fees were too high. Singapore's GIC, managing over $700 billion, allocates a significant portion to alternative investments, including hedge funds. They prefer diverse strategies and often partner with top quant firms. Billionaires and family offices also invest heavily in hedge funds. These private clients often operate like institutions, allocating to multiple managers. The exact numbers are usually confidential, but SEC filings occasionally reveal their footprints. Hedge funds don't advertise, but they're not invisible. Start with trade publications like Hedge Week, the Hedge Fund Journal, or Hedge Fund Alert for news and profiles. For U.S. stock holdings, funds managing over $100 million must file SEC Form 13F quarterly. Professional investors use subscription databases like Preqin, Hedge Fund Research, and Eureka Hedge. These offer performance data, strategy breakdowns, and peer comparisons. Want to meet fund managers? Summits like Hedge Fund Week in Miami are industry hubs if you can get in. They don't make it easy, but hedge funds leave a trail. If you know where to look, you can find them. If you found this useful, we'd love to keep in touch. Join our Aspiring Quants mailing list to get early access to new lessons, materials we don't post on YouTube, and a heads up when the full course goes live. It's low volume, no fluff, just solid updates for people who are serious about learning this stuff.